What's up, YouTube? Welcome to the channel. Let me start off by just thanking you guys for stopping by and checking it out. Today's video, we're going to get right into me, what I do on a day-to-day, that's installing furnaces, air conditioners, whatever it may be, HVAC tech by trade. I ain't going to talk you guys' ears off. Listen, let's just dive right into the video. Let's go. Alright, so we have made it to the job site. Already had a conversation with the homeowner. Came outside, grabbed tools, and we're gonna go inside and get ready, take a look at what we got. Alright now. So let's take a look at this equipment, see what we got going on. That's the pot and the Marcus right there. This looks like it's gonna be an easy one, buddy. Yeah. I'm gonna put 80 on up. I don't have no relax. So we gotta make sure this coil is gonna stay up. Shoot screws in this ductwork and make sure that it don't come out. Attach this coil. Hey then, so as you can see, that bad baby out of there. That bad baby sitting on there. The plan is bring down the new one and then work on that one, prep that one up and get that one ready to be put in. Would it take 20 minutes to get that thing out? Nothing. All right, I think first and foremost, we're gonna go ahead and get this return cut. Now, when I'm cutting the return, what I do is I take a look at the back side of the furnace. How far back, how many inches is that coming off? And I look at the bottom, how many inches from the bottom. And then that's how I make it on my new one. You feel me? I was cooked. Let's see. I'm gonna put one more right here just cause. I feel the rack is on. Also, keep good habit whenever you're pulling out these furnaces. Always check the coil. There'll be opportunities just waiting. This one don't look bad. Even though she might be a smoker. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna take this edge here and I'm gonna bend this in so this stays up under here flush instead of on the top, okay? So, look at that. Looks like a box now. Back, front. Let's see, like that. Good. On the other side, knock those out. So don't let this wiring confuse you. See, we got our stat wire, which is our 5 wire. And then we also have a humidifier. You see the humidifier is going to your home and the common. And then your AC wire, your 2 wire, that's always gonna go to your AC and the common. And then of course, hook those up. So that's the hookup. High voltage looks a little crazy, but this will work. So see, we got our whites tied together. We got a condo pump wired in there. Start up, check out the condo pump wire and everything, then we gotta get the thermostat wired up. Blue pipe. Just wanna check the wiring real quick. And the wiring is good. Alright, so now, just when I take my break, like I said, I come back through the flue. Make sure that's good. Gas and everything is done. Make sure we got a drip leg on there, sediment trap, whatever you want to call it. Existing. We kept that. That's existing. Put a few S slides on there. I'm going to put some silicone and then I'm going to tape it all the way around. I'm going to silicone first. Yeah, see like those sharp edges? Make sure we definitely put some silicone. We don't want nobody come near here playing around and scratch themselves up, so. And also down along here, we're gonna use, I might even put a piece of metal, like an L bracket, or either I'll just use some silicone right there. Same thing right here. So, let's get it. That's it. Take a little break first. So, while my partner's in there getting the thermostat put on, I'm enjoying me some of this heat. Drink me a shake. But anyway, I guess it's a good time to let you guys know a little bit about myself, okay? I've been doing HVAC now for about 8 years, I think. Started off as an apprentice, of course, still in school. Green is all outdoors. Within a year, I worked my way up to get my license, because whenever you go to school, and I went for 2 years for my associate's degree, and
anyway, it takes a year off of the hours needed, or the hours that you have to work in order to get or apply to take your journeyman's test. But anyway, it's after about a year, year and a half, give or take. Took my journeyman's test, failed it. I studied, went back, took it again, failed it. Finally, on the third try, I went back again. All this is within like a month and a half, because you gotta wait like 2 weeks, I think, before you can retake. So that third try, went back, took it, failed that bitch. I'm lying, passed it that time. And so, that's when I, about a month later, I say, that's whenever they gave me my own van and gave me an apprentice, and they looked back from there. But anyway, so I eventually left that company, worked my way up into service, started doing service, and really that's been the bulk of my career. I've been doing service for the last five, six years or whatnot. I just started back doing the install October 2020, right before Halloween. And so I may be going back to service come summertime, but who knows? It depends on what I want to do. I don't know. I kind of, you know, missed install a little bit. You know, the perks of install is you get to keep your scrap. So like ACs and furnaces and all that, you can scrap that for money. So just off the scrap alone, in this furnace season, you know, I put in every bit of about, I only work 4 days a week. So, and 4 days 1 week and then 5 days the next week. So I get about 4 to 5, 6 furnaces a week, and they're $5 a piece. So, bing, there you go. And that's just for me selling them to somebody that's going to go scrap them. So there you go. That. But in the AC season, when you get them coils, I'm making about an extra $300 to $500, $600 every month. Really, it's that good. And that's not counting the perks of, you know, selling stuff, maintenance plans, humidifiers, UV lights, I mean, anything. You always have to remember, just because you're an installer, that doesn't mean that you only come in and install. I'm not a robot. The best part about my job is talking to people, and I like talking to people, so, and find out what the people need in their home. So that's what we do. So the big question everybody has, you know, is there money, a lot of money, can you live comfortably just from working in HVAC? And the answer to that question is, yeah, changed my life, I'll be honest with you, changed my life, you know, and that's a story for another day when we have story time, but definitely, I ain't always had it, ain't always been peaches, you hear me, it was lemons at one point in time, but that's enough for now. Everybody's been able to put this whole piece on there. These snap together if you don't know. I have to use existing pipe that was here because the pipe is stuck on the truck and I can't get to it, so.
I feel like I gotta be all day thing to get that off. You're gonna have to knock that little front piece off. What should get it? You might have something wrong with the...
Yep.
Yeah,
PVC cleaner.
Just let you know, check gas pressure, make sure gas pressure is good. Put our filter in there. But I mean, pretty much done. Alright, install completed. We out. We're gonna check the phone and see what we got next. Good install. Didn't sell anything on that one. And AC was only 2 years old. The only play I had was the humidifier, and the humidifier just so happened to work, and the pad was decent. It is a little older though, but set up for the next guy. Something that a lot of people should do. Even if they don't do it, bring it up. But the next guy to come, you know, from the company you're at, hey, he might be the one to get that. She did say that in the, whenever we do our maintenance in the spring, that she'll definitely, you know, consider the humidifier at that time. But another day, another dollar, and another happy client.